10 cats. Princess of Darkness, Nellie Osbourne. Hair-raising funny man, Andy Zaltzman. And their team captain, Jason Manford. And facing them tonight, a puppet, Alex Zane. Canada Dry, Stewart Francis. And their team captain, John Lock. Now, welcome your host, Jimmy Carr.
Hello and welcome to 8 out of 10 Cats, a show about opinion polls, surveys and statistics. Did you know, for example, on average, in the Northern Hemisphere, January is the coldest month of the year. However, if you were in Australia, you'd be surrounded by twats. 30% of us refuse to sit on a public toilet seat, which is perhaps why they shit all over the floor. And the longest kiss on record lasted 130 hours. I'd like to see two beautiful women try and beat that. Let's get started. What are you talking about? That's the name of our first round. We've teamed up with a leading polling organisation and they've asked the British nation what stories they've been talking about this week. It's our panellists' job to guess the British public's top five most popular talking points. Sean, your team to go first.
I think people have been talking about the story about Starbucks, that they leave a tap running in every single Starbucks or throughout the world. And apparently, it's that the Starbucks excuse, because obviously it's caused shock and horror as a waste, Starbucks' excuse is that it's for hygiene reasons, because they put the spoons in it. So although it's not very hygienic, a tap running, isn't it? Because it attracts cats to sort of pour it. They love pouring the tap water, don't they? How ill can you get from a teaspoon? Anyway, I've got teaspoons in my house. They're disgusting. They look like they've passed through a Shire horse. I'm fine. Do you think there's a special hospital ward with people who can just blink one eyelid because they had a dirty teaspoon?
I'll tell you how ill you can get. Have you seen Pete Doherty?
Yeah.
That's all from teaspoons.
I had a friend in high school whose mother found out she was doing drugs and she had antique spoons that she'd destroyed, and that was what she was more upset with than the fact that her daughter was doing heroin. That she ruined her antique spoons.
What? Her daughter was doing heroin? She's gone, "You've cooked up in the good spoons."
Literally.
You're a disgrace.
Well, you can make a new daughter, but you'd have to buy a new spoon.
You said that, Andy, like you'd make one in a lab.
When you look at Osbourne, you think he might have made a kid in a lab.
I don't know how you can waste water. We've got the same amount of water as we've ever had. We're mostly water. The problem is it's in the wrong place. It's in Starbucks rather than Africa. That's the problem. The only people wasting water are people going into space, when it don't come back. That's the only people wasting water.
Damn you, Aldrin!
Did you know that Starbucks is an anagram of burst taps? It's not.
It's not.
I just like to cheat. Nobody really checks up on anagrams. They just assume you've done the work. They go, "Oh, really?" Nobody goes, "Hold on a sec."
That is a shocking indictment on our studio audience that they went, "Yeah."
You go into Starbucks, they do the fair trade question now. They go, do you want as a fair trade coffee? And who in that situation goes, "No, no, no, I want the other one. I don't want the fair trade. I want the exploito. Give me the exploito." Yeah. I really want to hurt some farmers. Make it massive and put a picture of a crying child on it for me.
Let's see if Starbucks is one of the most talked about things this week. Have been accused of wasting water by leaving taps constantly running. Starbucks have said the practice exists to exceed health and safety standards and they're working on an alternative solution as a priority. I've got a solution for you. What's that? And then that. Jason, Kelly, Andy, what else have the nation been talking about this week?
Andy?
Well, I think the American election has got the world really excited. Whoever wins on November the 4th, by virtue of following George W. Bush into the White House, they will seem to have been one of the five greatest presidents in American history. Following Bush into the White House is a bit like following Mozart in a triple jump competition. Because no matter how bad you are, he's been dead since the 18th century.
Hail in
someone accused Barack Obama of, palling around with terrorists,
yeah,
then,
yeah,
ironically, she excused herself because she had a lunch date with George W. Bush.
That's a funny phrase, though, isn't it, that she was palling around with terrorists. He's got some very loose ties with a bloke who 40 years ago was part of an anti-Vietnam War demonstration.
What's wrong with that?
Well, he did bomb the Pentagon.
Oh.
Barack Obama is an anagram of Bomb America.
There's still a few at the back where it started.
Sure. It might be. You don't know. You've got to check it.
Can I throw you a curveball with Sarah Palin?
Yeah, baby.
But she is so evil, she's sexy.
Like, what goes on in your brain?
On, like, you know, once she's killed all the polar bears, I want her to walk up and down my back in those heels.
Does he have a girlfriend? No wonder.
It's like a chat room on Bebo. One of her main character traits to sell her on is the fact that she shot a bear. When has that been a good thing? Like, vote for me, I threw a brick at a swan. Vote for me, I put mustard on a cat's arse. I'd want to vote for someone who said, vote for me, I opened the window for flies, you know.
I can tell you it's not one of the most talked about things this week. This is the story of mudslinging in the US election. Sarah Palin called Obama an embarrassment, which is the pot calling the kettle black, which thankfully she didn't say. Now, what else have the nation been talking about?
I think O.J. Simpson. Is it O.J. Simpson? He was convicted of kidnapping and...
Two memorabilia dealers.
And it doesn't look good. He was actually convicted, and they've got video. The prosecutors have video evidence against him. They have audio evidence against him. They've got numerous witnesses. I like his chances.
You think we're getting away with... I mean, you think we've been acquitted of murder. I think we got away with that. You would think, after that, you'd go, I'm going to keep my head down. You know what I mean?
Well, at least wear a balaclava. Because it's the two memorabilia dealers, holds them up, and they go, and when the police come, they go, yeah, it's him on that picture there, or any of the shirts that we sell.
Also, you just think about it, don't you? Think, what a country. Kill your wife, that's fine. Steal two signed footballs, life imprisonment.
Do people collect any of your bits and pieces, Jimmy? Do you have a memory bit? Did anyone collect anything of yours?
I think you should have a range of tabletop wargaming miniatures that all look like you.
Just use Lego Man. Little Lego Man.
They've got his haircut.
Yeah. You can talk. You're copying my haircut.
Mine's hip. It's a bit Hoxton. There you go.
Literally, that's it. That's all.
50 quid says someone comes on now to sort it out.
I'll do it. It's all right. I'm professional.
OK, shall we have a look and see whether OJ's one of the most talked about things this week?
Yay!
Incredibly, the second most talked about thing this week. This is the story that OJ Simpson has been convicted of kidnap and armed robbery. On the plus side for OJ, at least the man who killed his wife is finally behind bars. OK, what else have the nation been talking about, Jason?
It's probably the economic crisis again. I don't know a lot about global economics.
No.
That sounds like the start of a song. Yeah. I don't know much about global economics. I love you, baby.
They're saying now that they're going to save the banks. £50 billion, they're going to save the banks, which is 1,600 quid to each of the taxpayers, right? That's how much it's going to cost us. And I thought to myself, surely they could do it, they could fix it with emergency tax, right? You remember when you, like, get a job, when you first start a job, and you get your paycheck and you go, you've been working your arse off all week, and they go, £12.40. You go, oh, where's the rest of the money? Yeah. Oh, it's emergency tax, right? You can get it back in a few weeks or in April or something. Do that, but with those bankers who are getting away with £3 million severage pay, get them ringing the tax office next week going, hey, I'm supposed to have 3 million quid here, but I've only got £15. What's happened? It's emergency tax, Norbert. Deal with it.
It would work, yeah. While it would work.
We all knew deep down that this bubble of prosperity we've enjoyed in recent years would burst. And I hope we learn some lessons. I think there's some important lessons to be learned.
What have you learned?
Well, I think I've learned from the subprime crisis that if you lend a lot of money to people who have no way of paying that money back, they might not pay that money back. Kind of thing, you can only learn that by trial and error. Yeah. Oh, that's the only way to learn that.
The last time where the world experienced this was in 1929. There was a great crash. And the reason people don't really know much about it or the reasons behind it is because when you're at school, you learn about the Tudors. She's very bleeding useful, isn't it? So you've lost your house or your savings, but if Henry VIII comes up in a pub quiz, watch me go to work.
Let's have a look and see whether the economy is one of the most talked about things this week. Of course.